I would like for you to do is just to give me some of your best memories of Michael Jackson.
Well, I didn't know him as a singer or entertainer. We spent many hours together. I couldn't tell you two of his friends. We talked about what is love, what is hate, what is racism, what is prejudice, what is segregation. I knew him as a five-year-old child in a grown man's body. And it's like when you wear your mother's shoes when you're a little girl, or your father's shoes. You have limits. You can't run in them. You can't walk up the steps in them. Well, he was 50 years old in a little boy's body. He didn't do the normal things that children do. He didn't have to sweat out a test. Okay? He didn't have to get ready and stay up and sit at tutors. I told him one day, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if you didn't know that you couldn't cook dinner at home because you've been in the room service. So, if, you see, we're so busy appreciating the talent and what he gave us, we forgot to see who was giving it to us. Okay? And so I looked at today and I said, wow. I went walking this morning and I was thinking that the world stood still today. And I bet if you took your cameras and can check out the whole world, crime was down.
Yes.
Something in the universe. And the one thing that nobody dawned on him is today we looked at all of this here for a descendant of a slave.
Huh? This is true.
And then you think about how far we have come from being snatched against our will, brought to a country of a language we don't speak, and in less than 500 years created an individual that the whole world had to take a deep breath of. And you trace that back to the black woman and the black church. We're the only group on this planet that can come from the bottom and make it to the top in one generation. The Kennedys, it took them 7 generations with a lot of thievery and gangster, okay? Jesse Jackson, one of the brilliant minds on the planet. Didn't know his daddy. Mama uneducated. Where'd Jesse come from? Black woman, black church. You got a governor, a black man is governor of Massachusetts. Deval Patrick. Born and raised in a housing project, one of the worst housing projects in the world, in Chicago. Robert Taylor Holmes. Mother, grandmother, two other brothers and sisters. 3 children. Bunk bed. Every third day, one had to sleep on the floor. He ends up going to Harvard Law. So brilliant, Exxon brought him in to handle the legal affair. He had Clinton appointing him U.S. attorney of a war-white state, and now he's governor of a white state. Trace that back to what? Black woman, black church. So that's what we look at. When you see him, what he was able to do, because he didn't put no limits on himself. Why? Because he was a child. No child put a damn limit on himself. Nobody say, I can't do this. Okay? Never roller skate. Never had fun on a bike. Never had fun playing basketball or football. So everything he had was channeled into what he was doing, and he did it well. Shit, if you stood up on your toes and moonwalked 18 and 19 hours a day, you know? But what he gave us with all of that, that my grandchildren can moonwalk just looking at it.
Yes.
See, I don't have to go through the preliminaries. And so when I look at him, look at today, it defied gravity. And nobody noticed any better when you with the numbers. What he did defied gravity.
Yes.
And that's what we saw today. And in that Staples Center today, had it not been no entertainers there, just the people, you could have felt something. Nobody was angry. Nobody was pushing. Nobody was making noise. Nobody was. And it was a respectability everybody had for themselves. And it transformed. You could feel it. You could hear it. You could just go through that whole piece. And so that's what we looked at today. Someone that a boy boy's mind, a child's mind, that didn't know that I'm not supposed to be able to do that. And I'll finish by saying this here. Every general and every military and every engineer that make weapons will look at his life, because then they'll find out what they're doing is not weapons of mass destruction. What he did is a weapon of mass destruction with love and kindness. Look at the civil rights movement, greatest movement in the history of the planet. We did it with no guns, no meanness, no bitterness, because had we tried it, it would have been over. So that was his life. That was his legacy. One person put it over here, and then it took a child. A child that didn't figure it out. If you run into a hotel that's on fire and do something, you're a hero. If a five-year-old child run, there ain't no damn hero. They didn't know the odds. They just went in to get their toy.
Yeah.
You know, and so that's what we looked at today. An end of one of the most incredible things that have ever happened in the history of the planet. It never happened before, and it won't happen again.
This is true.
If you looked at the Wright brothers, never happened before. We got missiles and rockets and all kinds of planes, but had it not been for that, we wouldn't be there. And that's what Michael gave us as a little child. And that's what we witnessed today.
Thank you so very much.